Today's speeches by Hitler and Daladier left the position of both sides on peace about where it was before. The French premier reiterated that the French cannot have their security imperiled every 6 months, that they want cooperation between nations but cannot submit to the dictates of violence. Hitler repeated that Germany has no reason to fight the Western powers, but added, quote, "The decision no longer rests with us. Whatever the rest of the world chooses, it will receive," end quote. Chamberlain's statement in the House of Commons has been postponed till Thursday to permit consultation with the Dominions, so it sounds as if he might go into detail about British war aims. Berlin was thrown into excited jubilation this morning by false reports that the British government had resigned and an armistice had been signed. The government radio later ascribed these rumors to what it called the dark plans of British warmongers. President Roosevelt told his press conference today that he had received no formal request to mediate in the war, and indirectly suggested that too much importance needn't be ascribed to the stories in Berlin that his mediation would be welcome. The Senate went on discussing the neutrality bill after voting down 65 to 26 the proposal of Senator Toby of New Hampshire to separate the clause for repeal of the arms embargo from cash and carry and the other sections. Meanwhile, repeal with qualifications gained an unexpected supporter in ex-President Hoover, who said tonight that he favored permitting the sale of anti-aircraft guns and ammunition and of observation and pursuit planes, since these could serve only as instruments of defense, particularly of civilians. He would prohibit the sale to anybody at any time of weapons of attack on civilians, bombing planes, bombs, poison gas, and submarines. This, said Mr. Hoover, would avoid the extreme objections and dangers of either repeal or no repeal, and would enable both sides in the war to protect their women and children. Earlier this evening, we brought you a report from Eric Severide of our Paris office, now in Belgium, who described the defensive concentrations of the Belgian troops and said the Belgians seem confident that they can keep out of the war. Since then, we have received the first report of Bill Henry, now at the front in France, with the British Air Force, which has come to us via London. So far, he says, the British have not carried a single bomb across the lines, only propaganda leaflets. He told of one British pilot who had to bail out in his parachute far inside German territory, but was blown across to the Maginot Line, where the Frenchman who received him presented him with the insignia of the troops serving in the line, a circle of barbed wire around a gun muzzle sticking out of a concrete emplacement with the motto, "They shall not pass." In the East, the Finns act as if they're getting ready to fight before they go the way of the three republics south of the Baltic. The government has suggested evacuation of Helsingfors and Viborg, the two cities which would be most immediately threatened by a Russian attack. It has strengthened the frontier defenses and is said to have 250,000 men under arms, so that seems a very high figure. Just what the Russian demands are is not yet known, but the Russian manner is making all the Scandinavians worry. According to a British broadcast, the Swedish newspaper Aftonbladet says that all the northern states might take the attitude that their position will be determined by the Russian moves toward Finland. However, reports of threatening Russian naval concentrations are denied. The Turkish Foreign Minister Sarakoglu, representing the other small nation that is not yet ready to give Stalin everything he demands, spent his 16th day in Moscow waiting for the Russians to get around to talking to him again. According to a German broadcast, he's spending his time at the circus and the opera. In London, they say that Turkey has already gone this far toward meeting Russian wishes. Its treaties will provide that Turkey helps Romania if Romania is attacked by Germany, but not if attacked by Russia. The campaign against Russia in the Italian press still goes on, but not so violently. The papers are now criticizing the Russians for communizing the occupied districts of Poland, but are asking why the British and French don't declare war on Russia, too. The evacuation of the Germans from the Baltic states, which was the provocation for this outburst, continues. And now we hear from Berlin that plans are being laid for similar removal of the Germans from Romania, Hungary, and Yugoslavia, nearly 2 million of them all told. Where are they going to put that many people in Germany? Whatever else this means, it seems a clear indication that the Drang nach Osten is over. No more will the German sword, as Hitler once phrased it, win land for the German plow. It looks as if Russian intervention has blocked off German expansion in the East. Germany must expand to the West or overseas or stop expanding.
This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.